Hello, my name is Randy Heater, Director of Product Management in Oracle Development. I'm here today with Bob Tome, Senior Director of Product Management for Oracle Real Application Clusters, commonly known as Oracle RAC. Hi, Bob.
Hi, Randy. It's great to be here.
Many of you are relatively new to Oracle RAC and may be curious as to how RAC became the industry's leading high availability cluster database solution. Bob's been at Oracle for over 15 years, not quite as long as Oracle has been working on this technology, but he nevertheless has a good handle on the product's evolution. Bob, can you take a few minutes to explain the evolution of Oracle RAC?
Oracle announced Oracle RAC in 2001, so the product is now 13 years old and quite mature. But the evolution of RAC started long before 2001. It started in Oracle 7 with a product called Oracle Parallel Server, or OPS. OPS was Oracle's first parallel database, a database that could span multiple servers in a cluster, with all servers working together to satisfy requests. OPS brought great advantages over single-instance databases.
I'm going to guess a big one was high availability.
Exactly. If an instance was running on one of the servers, or the server itself were to fail, a surviving instance running on a surviving server would perform recovery, and the surviving instances would continue to provide services. Because the database was already running on the surviving nodes, recovery was faster than that provided by competing cold failover solutions. A second advantage was scalability. OPS could spread a single database workload across more than one server, so customers could take advantage of lower costs, smaller servers, and could grow their database capacity by adding servers if and when needed.
It sounds like OPS did it all. Why then did we introduce RAC?
Good question. With OPS, only certain types of workloads would scale across multiple servers. If servers tried to work on the same data block, the first instance would need to flush the block to disk so the second instance could read the data. Since the disks are the slowest components in the system, this dramatically slowed the system, offsetting the benefits of scaling the work across the nodes. In some cases, customers would overcome these limitations by artificially partitioning their data by server to minimize the contention on any one piece of data.
I'll bet this required modifying the application, and therefore it didn't work well with most real-world applications. So Oracle introduced RAC to provide a high availability and scalability solution that addressed these issues. Tell us about that.
In 2001, Oracle introduced Oracle RAC as an option to Oracle 9i. Oracle RAC introduced an improved method of sharing data across the instances in the cluster. Rather than flushing unsaved dirty blocks to disk so another instance could read the data, Oracle RAC is able to pass the block across the network to the requesting instance. Since the network is orders of magnitude faster than flushing the block to disk and reading it into memory, Oracle RAC is able to scale without rewriting the applications.
In other words, it is able to run real-world applications, hence the name Oracle Real Application Clusters. Now, Oracle RAC provided both high availability and scalability for all applications.
This was a breakthrough. However, Oracle RAC was a challenge to install and support. It relied on various third-party components, such as a clusterware component and a shared storage manager. Integrating Oracle RAC with these third-party components was a pain point for customers.
So tell us how Oracle addressed these pain points.
In Oracle 10G, Oracle made some great enhancements to Oracle RAC. To address the complexity, Oracle began providing its own clusterware, Oracle Clusterware, and storage manager, Oracle Automatic Storage Management, or ASM. Now, Oracle provided the entire stack for the RAC deployment, putting an end to the complexity of integrating and supporting third-party components into the cluster. In addition, ASM provided many features that simplified managing storage, going well beyond the features provided by third parties. Also with ASM, storage became an elastic pool, making it simple to share disk I/O and storage capacity across databases and to add or remove storage while the database was online.
So now, Oracle provided a complete stack from the operating system up through the application. I can see how that would dramatically simplify implementation issues.
Definitely. Oracle 10G also improved upon the flexibility of the database, introducing database services as a way to manage multiple workloads running in a shared cluster. Now, resources could be aligned with workload requirements, giving customers greater control over resources to simplify meeting their quality of service objectives, even as demand changed over time.
And when combined with the flexible storage pools introduced with ASM, Oracle now provided true elasticity for database services. By the time Oracle introduced Oracle Database 10G Release 2, customers were creating shared infrastructure clusters based on Oracle Rack that provided not just HA and scalability, but also flexibility and agility. Okay, tell us about Oracle Database 11G and what that meant for Rack.
With Oracle Database 11G, Oracle made Rack even easier to deploy and manage. This was done in two ways. Perhaps most importantly, Oracle introduced Oracle Engineered Systems as a deployment platform for Oracle Rack. Oracle Exadata, first introduced on Oracle Database 11G, is fundamentally a prepackaged Oracle Rack cluster. Now, customers could order a single product and get a fully functional, highly available, and scalable Rack cluster deployed within days of receiving their hardware. Later, we introduced Oracle Database Appliance, which introduced engineered systems to a new class of smaller customers, letting them too deploy highly available Rack databases without the deep knowledge previously required.
And once Oracle combined with Sun, Oracle was able to provide the entire stack, including the underlying hardware. So what was the focus of Oracle Database 11G Release 2?
In Oracle Database 11G Release 2, we introduced many manageability features, including a streamlined deployment using Oracle Universal Installer, improved patching, and a new deployment model called Policy Managed Databases, which simplified database and service placement in a cluster using policies rather than administrator-managed placement.
So what did customers do with these new capabilities?
All this flexibility made Rack an ideal platform for database consolidation. Customers began consolidating multiple databases within a Rack cluster to enable pooling and sharing of resources across all their databases. Also, in contrast to VM-style consolidation, cluster consolidation reduced the number of operating systems requiring management. This reduced the workload of systems, network, and storage administrators. Database administrators, hoping to reduce their workload, began consolidating databases into larger Rack databases, using schemas to isolate individual workloads. This provided the best manageability benefits, but often required modifying the application to avoid namespace collisions.
And as we discussed earlier, you never want to expect customers to modify their applications to take advantage of a new feature. Since consolidation is a key requirement and motivation for building a private cloud, I understand we made simplifying consolidation a priority in Oracle Database 12c.
Yes. Our newest release, Oracle Database 12c, establishes Oracle Rack as the premier infrastructure for building private database clouds. It improves the previous release in many ways. Headlining the release is the new Oracle Multi-Tenant Architecture, an architecture that allows customers to consolidate databases without changes or namespace collisions. Customers can now benefit from managing many databases as one, yet still get the isolation they require between databases. The release also introduces automatic quality of service management for everyone, whereby resources are allocated based on policies and reallocated as demand changes based upon target performance metrics. It ensures your most important workloads will meet their performance objectives, perhaps at the expense of your less important workloads. And the release provides breakthroughs in high availability with application continuity. Application continuity masks database failures from the applications themselves, eliminating the disruption caused by failures at the database tier, and ensuring end users can continue to work uninterrupted.
That sounds pretty impressive, and it takes us to today. Where will we go in the future with Rack?
Looking to the future, Oracle will continue to enhance Oracle Rack, cementing its place as the foundation of the private cloud and database as a service. Look for innovative features to facilitate running databases in a cloud environment, providing the highest levels of availability, the simplest deployment and management, massive scalability, and deterministic quality of service. Oracle Rack is and will continue to be a massive differentiator for the Oracle database, popular with everyone, from small and mid-size to enterprise customers.
Thanks, Bob, for this overview. Suffice it to say, Oracle isn't resting on its laurels. It continues to aggressively invest in Rack. The development resources dedicated to Rack have never been greater. it will be very interesting to see where the technology takes us and how it drives the evolution of IT.